Hey guys, welcome you all in this brand new video. This video is all about 15 free Blender add-ons. But before that, I would like to special mention a paid add-on, Scatter. Scatter is a great add-on and is on top of my favorite add-ons. As the name specifies, this add-on provides you an excellent scattering system inside of Blender. And they have recently released a new update, Scatter Season 3.0. And this update comes with tons of features that you would definitely like. And you would be eager to purchase it immediately if you do not have already purchased it. This add-on is far better than Blender's internal scattering system. This add-on is extremely useful if you are working with terrains and you need to scatter grass, weeds, trees, rocks, etc. on the landscape. This add-on will do your work within a few clicks and way better than Blender's internal scattering system. Plus, this add-on comes with a proxy system so that you can see your assets with viewport optimized. And to make your work even faster, this add-on comes with biomes. Biomes are a set of assets like grass, weeds, dried leaves, etc. And there are a lot of more features available. This add-on is available for $60 on the Blender Market. A link to the add-on is in description. Visit it just after watching this video. I will be going to discuss 15 add-ons in 10 minutes, starting with the first add-on, Animation Nodes. Animation Nodes is a node-based visual scripting system designed for motion graphics in Blender. If you are a motion graphics designer, then it is possible that you already know this add-on. And soon, this type of node-based system will be in the Blender itself, as they are working on a similar project, Everything Nodes. I will be mentioning the links to all these add-ons in the description under the video, so that if you want to get them, you can instantly click there and download it. Animation Nodes is an excellent add-on, and there are a lot of tutorials available for it if you want to learn. And also there is a proper documentation available on their website. Daily builds are accessible on Blender's community website Graphical. Coming next, we have Photographer add-on. This is one of the most excellent free add-ons for Blender. It has both free and paid versions. The paid version is available for $6 on Blender Market and Gumroad. But the free version is only available on Gumroad. Photographer 2 adds physical camera settings to your Blender camera, while Photographer 3, which is a paid add-on, also adds physical light settings into the Blender. This add-on works for Cycles, Eevee and LuxCore render engines. Photographer is one of my favorite add-ons, as this adds a lot of functionality to your camera, like autofocus, real camera settings, like ISO, aperture, shutter speed, and many more artist-friendly controls, all in one place. Next is Building Tools add-on. And this allows you to build a house in edit mode within a few clicks. The add-on has very easy user interface and very helpful for beginners. And with some effort, of course, you can even use it for ArcViz. Using this add-on, you can create windows, doors, railings, balcony, roof, etc. and maybe much more in the future. And I expect a huge improvement in this add-on, as it can challenge ArchiPack and ArchiMesh if it continues to improve, as it has a lot of possibilities. Next is Draw Pitch add-on. Very simple and very cool add-on. It has nothing much to explain. It is what you can see, or at least understand from its name. Draw Pitch is a very useful option for snapping objects to surfaces, just like floors, tables, or any horizontal surfaces. You can just click on Draw Pitch and it will automatically snap to the surface without being through the surface. If you want to place an object over a floor or a table or some kind of horizontal surface, you need to align it and keep it on the surface so that it does not be above the surface or somewhat through the object. I find this add-on very useful, and now this is part of my tool set. You can get it for free on the Gumroad. The link is in description. Next is Extra Lights. This add-on is from CG Cookie, the creators of Blender Market itself. This add-on has both paid and free versions. Even its paid version is not very expensive, it is just worth $14. Now let me talk about its free version, as this video is about free add-ons. This add-on gives you real world units and values for your lights and make it physically correct. This add-on has a total of 21 light presets in the free version and 40 more in the paid version. You will get different real world light presets like candle, moon, car, headlight, floodlights, and many more. You can find it on Jonathan Lampel's GitHub page, who is creator of this add-on. Next is Bygen. This is very popular add-on, and you already may know this. Bygen contains a collection of tools for creating generative content inside of Blender. This add-on includes techniques for non-destructive generative modeling, as well as structured generators that allow you to build modular structures from pre-made parts, powered by Blender's collection system. Next is Visual Scripting add-on. This is not very popular, but I find it very cool. As its name specifies, this add-on provides you some node-based user interface to create add-ons. You can create panels, operators, and many more cool things with this. Although it is at its beginning stage and the add-on has its alpha release, this add-on is maintained on a Discord server and new releases are uploaded there time to time. There is not much documentation available, but still you can get help on the Discord server, and also some examples are loaded with this to get started. Overall, I would like to say it is a very cool and excellent add-on, and with some improvement, this add-on has a lot of possibilities. Next is MB Labs add-on, also known as Manual Bastiolina Labs. It's a very cool add-on for creating characters like in any other 3D character creating softwares like Real Illusions Character Creator. Characters created with this add-on are of good and professional topology, and there are hundreds of morphing parameters to shape your character. You can create anime stylized characters as well as extremely realistic characters. Proper documentation is available for this add-on so that you can understand what each and every parameter does. A good number of presets are available for the characters. You can also animate facial expressions using this add-on. While talking about this add-on, I would like to mention a free software, MakeHuman, which is open source, and you can also use this software for creating characters and then you can import them in Blender. Next is SphereShock Nodes. It is a very popular add-on and is a parametric tool built to help generate complex 3D shapes using a node system to control the flow of math and geometry. It is ideally suited to architects and designers, but anyone with high school math and trigonometry will be able to produce results that are impossible to achieve unless you know text-based programming languages such as Python or C. Those familiar with Houdini, Dinosaurus 3D, Dynamo or other modular systems should feel at home using this add-on. Personally, I have not used this add-on, but I find this add-on very useful for those who want to generate complex 3D shapes using nodes. Proper documentation is available to get familiar with the nodes. You can download this add-on from their GitHub page or from their website. Next is KitOps. Now, I'm pretty sure that you may have already heard about this add-on, as this is very popular add-on. KitOps is from the developers of another most popular add-ons, HardOps and BoxCutter. The add-on has two versions, the free one and a paid one. Paid one is for around $35, while free one being free misses some cool features. But never mind, it can still be very helpful for you. This add-on will be a magic for you if you are into hard surface modeling. KitOps is a kit bashing add-on for Blender. Using this, you can add assets, also known as inserts, to your scenes, non-destructively. With the free version, you get some inserts with it, but if you want to have some more, you can buy inserts available on their store. You can get the add-on for free on Gumroad. The link is in description. Next is ArchiPack. You may have seen this add-on, as this comes imported with Blender, but I think you need to enable, as it may not be enabled by default. If you are not familiar with this add-on, then you may face an small issue. Is when you are just about to add a window or door or any of the available options, there are no presets visible. So for this, you need to click on Render Presets thumb under Preferences, and this will start rendering thumbnails in background. It can take 3 to 10 minutes depending on your PC's performance. And after rendering, here you can see the thumbnails for the available presets. All the presets are very cool, and this add-on is very helpful for ArchViz. You can also use ArchiMesh, that also comes with Blender, is an option. There are various options available in ArchiPack, such as you can create doors, windows, fans, roof, stairs, etc. And in ArchiMesh, you have further more options available like cabinets, shelves, curtains, books, lamps, etc. So overall, I would like to say they are pretty cool add-on for ArchViz. ArchiPack has also a paid version where you get some more presets and options. If you want, you can purchase, or otherwise you can stick to the free one. Next is Blender GIS. I've already discussed this add-on in my previous video about add-ons. But still, for those who have not watched that video, I would like to say this add-on is very cool and one of my favorite add-ons for generating real-world terrains directly into the Blender. You can also import the shapefile and also files in some other formats, like you can import files from SRCT engine. This add-on is useful for importing real-world terrains with textures directly into the Blender. You can also import OSM data using this add-on. The add-on has a very simple user interface. Next is Mixer. You may have heard about this earlier, as it was released recently and it became popular news for the Blender community. It is an excellent add-on, and it is developed at Ubisoft Animation Studio for real-time collaboration in 3D Edition. It allows multiple Blender users to work on the same scene at the same time. It is also possible to implement a connection for other 3D editing software. Next is Screencast Keys. It is a very useful add-on for educators. As the name specifies, using this add-on, anyone can display on screen what key is being pressed on keyboard or mouse so that viewers can follow along. You can decide the color, size and location of the screencast keys, and few more parameters are customizable. That's it, it is a very simple but useful tool. And the last add-on is M-Tree. And you may have heard about this add-on, as this is one of the popular add-ons. M-Tree is also known as Modular Tree. It is a node-based tree generator add-on, and it allows you to create fully skinned and unwrapped trees. You can generate realistic trees with the help of this add-on. It is very easy to use it, but if you want to know what each node does, there are a lot of tutorials available on YouTube, but I don't think you need them. is the name of each node specifies what that node does. Suppose you create trunk node, it will create tree trunk, and branch node will create branches. And in the same way, twig node creates twig. I love this add-on and I generally use this whenever I need to generate trees inside of the Blender. You can download this add-on from its GitHub page. The link will be in the description. I have also listed some more interesting add-ons in the description. You can comment down if I missed any of the add-ons, and I will list them too in the description if I find it relevant, so that it will be helpful for others to access them. Till then, thank you, bye bye, and see you in the next video.